All right, so in today's review, we're going to take a look at Amcrest's 4K USB webcam. And I'm excited to take a look at this one because Amcrest so far in my previous reviews have gotten something uniquely wrong with each one of their prior models. Either it's been something with odd distortion, or my skin tone is all weird, or the microphone's terrible. So today we're going to go ahead and unbox this 4K USB camera, set it up on my Windows 10 PC, and then compare the image and audio quality. All right, welcome back everyone. Today we're taking a look at Amcrest's latest USB webcam release, this 8 megapixel AWC897 4K webcam. This webcam includes a physical privacy cover, built-in stereo microphone, and uses USB for plug-and-play setup on both Mac and Windows. The AWC897 has an upgraded 8 megapixel image sensor, but still only about a 1 over 3.2 inch CMOS sensor, which is what you'd get on an iPhone 5 for comparison's sake. The upgraded image sensor is supposed to get you up to 4K resolution at 18 frames per second, but if you want to do something more normal, like 30 frames per second, that is supported at 1440p or 1080p. Later in the review, we'll see how much you can get in frame with the 75 degree field of view, and we'll also test the built-in microphone, which has been dicey on some of their other models. This model is still USB 2.0 plug and play for both Mac and Windows, and it includes a 5-foot-9-inch long cable that is permanently attached, but should get you good reach to your computer. So now let's open up the box and see what we have inside. There's our privacy cover. The screw mount on the bottom allows you to attach this to a 1/4-inch tripod mount, or you can clamp this on your monitor. So let's just twist that up here. So here's your microphone, your lens, and your power indication. So now let's set this up on my Windows computer and see how it performs. So the clamp design of the Amcrest webcam makes this very easy to attach to the top of your screen. As you can see, we have these rubberized cushions on the back, which keeps things sticky and firmly in place. So all you have to do is put it on top of your monitor and pinch here, and now the webcam is firmly in place on the top of my screen.
All right, so when I plugged the webcam into my computer, Windows instantly picked it up as a USB 2.0 webcam and installed all the necessary drivers. Now, Amcrest doesn't ship with any kind of recording software itself, and is gonna rely on something like your streaming software, whether that be OBS Studio, or Skype, or Zoom, or Google Hangouts, or Microsoft Teams. So it's gonna show up as a webcam inside of there that you just select as a video source. So now let's switch from this Canon 70D to the Amcrest AWC897. And as you can probably tell with the same level of brightness in the room, that I'm a little bit blasted out here by the lights. So let me bring that down a little bit to see if we can pick up some more detail. So yeah, I'd say under more normal lighting conditions, it looks pretty good. This is a tremendous step up from some of the other Amcrest models that I've reviewed in the past. My skin tones here look much more natural, and this one's supposed to work really well in lower light conditions. So I imagine that's why with the higher light output, I was getting like blown out by the highlights. So at about 30 inches away from the camera, the focus looks pretty good, but it is a fixed focus, so you have to move the camera either closer or farther away to get that optimum sweet spot. So this AWC897 seems to have solved all the issues that I had seen with previous models with regard to color balance and brightness and some distortion along the edges. So this would make a really good webcam, but now that I've said that, the one thing that has really disappointed me in all of their webcams so far has been their microphone. It's either been muddy or sounding like it's underwater or too soft. So let's go ahead and switch over from my external microphone now to the internal microphone and see how it sounds.
All right, so now you're listening to me using the built-in microphone on the Amcrest AWC897. And as you can probably hear, it's a pretty big disappointment. It's just not something that Amcrest has seemed to be able to correct yet. Amongst all the other improvements to this model, the microphone is just not there yet. They've made it extremely loud and heavy with the treble, which maybe is good for picking up a large room if you're just trying to listen to the audio, but it's on a one-on-one basis not awesome. So I would definitely recommend pairing this with an external mic.
And so that you can hear the rest of this review, we're just gonna go ahead and switch over to that external mic right now. All right, so in summary, I'd say that this is actually the best Amcrest webcam that I've reviewed so far. The color is much better, the resolution is much higher, the focal length is pretty good. I'm not getting distortions around the edges, but the microphone's still not there. So if you're willing to pair this with an external mic like I'm doing right now, I think you have a winning combination for a budget setup. You can often find these on sale, and paired with an external mic, I think you've got yourself a good bargain here, especially if you're still working from home or your kids are doing remote schooling or something like that. Definitely give this a shot. So I'll leave more information about recommended microphones down in my video description down below. And if you enjoyed this video review, please click on the like button and consider subscribing to my channel for more great tech reviews. And thanks for watching.